Hi students, how are you all? So we are going to continue with the next chemical property of cyanide compound, thorpe nitrile condensation reaction. So condensation reaction means just like a addition reaction with or without elimination of small molecules like water, ammonia. So in this condensation we are going to take 2 moles of propane nitrile. For example, CH3, CH2, C triple bond N, which is treated with another 1 mole of propane nitrile, that you can write CH3, CH2, CN. In the presence of sodium ether, we will get some immuno compound. See how here the CH2 having 2. Hydrogen, you know, one of the hydrogen you can take it out, that you can add with this carbon, the remaining group you can add the nitrogen, so we will get some immuno group. Okay, the hydrogen you want to add the nitrogen, remaining group you are carbon, so triple bond becoming double bond. So what is the product? CH3 CH2 in the carbon. We have to add CH CN CH3. So this group we have to add in the carbon. Then one bond will reduce, the double bond. There is a nitrogen in the carbon. Nitrogen with one hydrogen we have to add. This is called immuno group. Okay. So double bond O present means amide group. Nitrogen present means that is immuno group. So 4 immuno 2 methyl pentane nitrile is the name of this compound. Okay, then similar type of a condensation reaction with ester. So both condensation, next one we will see, both will undergo in the presence of, or the compounds would have the alpha hydrogen. See, alpha carbon, alpha hydrogen, functional group, alpha carbon, alpha hydrogen. The same way the next condensation reaction is Levin-Kaser condensation reaction. Here we are going to take ethyl propionate. Propionate means CH3, CH2, COO, then ethyl group, which is treated with ethane nitrile, that means CH3 CN group. Here we have to take the catalyst alcohol, soda amine, Na NH2 NH3 soda amine, and also we have to take the acid presence H+. Now, what type of condensation reaction will take place? Here the C double bond O you can write like this. Now you can add the CH3. How do you split the CH3? As usual, one of the alpha hydrogen, the previous also we have taken, right? That alpha hydrogen you can add in the oxygen, remaining group you add in the carbon, double bond becoming single bond. So write the product CH2 COH single bond. Already we have C2H5, in down we can write CH2 CN group. Okay, so this is also called heteropentanitrile. See, actually here further hydrolysis reaction will take place. So what will happen? This CH2 group, C2H5 group will go as a ethane. So actually this step they didn't give in the book. CH3, CH2, C double bond O, CH2, CN. Ketone with 5 carbon nitrile. So heteropentanitrile. Okay. So this step not necessary, but you can come to know, right? So the chemical reactions of cyanide over. Now we are going to learn about isocyanide. So cyanide means the CN compound is called cyanide. The compound N triple bond C, NC present means the cyanide is reversed, means we can say isocyanide. Alkyl isocyanide we can say. Common name isocyanide. What is IUPAC name? Carbylamine. Carbylamine compound. Alkyl carbylamine. So the same way by using this we can name for some iso compound. The first one, methyl isocyanide. So this is methyl group, prefix you have to add, suffix you have to write carbylamine. So methyl carbylamine. If you take ethyl group, CH3, CH2, NC, ethyl carbylamine. So likewise, based on that prefix group, simply you can add the suffix carbylamine. Okay. If you take benzene ring, CCH5CN, so carbylamine, phenyl carbylamine. Phenyl carbylamine. So likewise we can give the IUPAC name for isocyanide compound. Now some preparation of isocyanide. So well known preparation already we have studied in previous lesson, carbylamine reaction. So carbylamine reaction means what type of catalyst will you take? Chloroform and also potassium hydroxide. So here ethylamine, primary amine CH3NH2 is treated with chloroform HCl3. What's the name? Molecular formula for chloroform CHCl3 with 3 moles of potassium hydroxide. So what will happen? Listen, 3Cl3K potassium chloride will go out. Then 3 OH, 3 hydrogen, 3 water molecules will go out. So what is the remaining? CH3NC. We will get isocyanate compound with 3 moles of KCl, 3 moles of water. Okay. If you take the place of CH3, C6H5, phenyl group, the same type of reaction will take place. 3 KCl will go, 1 plus 2, 3 hydrogen, 3 OH, water will go. So we will get phenyl isocyanide, 3H2O. Okay. Then another preparation by taking alkyl halide with silver cyanide, AgCN. Okay. Alkyl cyanide, alkyl halide like ethyl bromide is treated with silver cyanide, CN. So AgBr will go out, CN you can add, but we want to prepare isocyanide. So how the isocyanide will form? Additionally you want to take ethyl alcohol. So because of this medium, nitrogen will attack the carbon. So CH3CH2NC isocyanide will form. Okay. The next preparation from formamide. First tell me what is the molecular formula for formic acid? HCOOH. This is called formic acid. Okay. So in the formic acid, if you add one NH2 group, it is called formamide compound. Okay. Then this formamide also substituted with CH3. Methyl formamide. What's the name of this compound? Formamide, which is having N substitution with CH3. So methyl formamide. So methyl formamide on heating itself, it will give water, H and oxygen, two hydrogen, one oxygen. Water will go out. What's the remaining? CH3 here. Form amide only, so O won't come. CH3NC plus H2O, right? So from formamide we can prepare isocyanide. So these are the three preparation of isocyanide compound. Then some physical property. It is also colorless liquid, but we have studied that cyanide having sweet smell, but here unpleasant smell, irritating smell will produce, and also it is heavier poison than cyanide, but which having low boiling point because of less polarity. Okay, then it is also sparingly or less soluble in water, highly soluble in organic solvent, right? Some chemical reactions. First, hydrolysis reaction. Methyl cyanide in the presence of water, hydrolysis reaction. So usually if you hydrolysis, we will get formamide first. After that we will get acid compound. But here what will happen? Directly we will get amine compound. How? This water molecule you have to take two times from four hydrogen. You take two hydrogen, add in the nitrogen. What is the remaining? Two hydrogen, two oxygen. You add with this carbon, will get formic acid. What's the remaining? CH3NH2. Amine compound with formic acid will form. Okay. So hydrolysis of isocyanide. Isocyanide. NC if you have to write. It will produce amine compound with formic acid preparation. The next chemical reaction, reduction of isocyanide with sodium CH3 NC with sodium ethyl alcohol reducing agent. So we can take 6 moles of hydrogen. Okay. What type of product will form? Secondary amine compound. So 4 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen you want to add in the nitrogen, 3 hydrogen you want to add in the carbon. So you will get CH3NH CH3. This is dimethyl amine. It is an example for secondary amine. Already we know that if you reduce the primary amine, it will give cyanide compound. The same way secondary amine will give isocyanide compound. Okay, right. The next chemical property, on heating with 250 degrees Celsius, it will give cyanide compound. CH3N(CC) compound on heating with 250 degrees Celsius heating, it will undergo rearrangement. This methyl group will shift towards a carbon. So CH3C(N) cyanide compound will form. So if you want to convert isocyanide to cyanide, we can heat at 250 degrees Celsius. At last, we are going to take addition reaction. So cyanide with addition with isocyanide, addition with halogen compound X2, any halogen Cl2 like. What will happen? These two Cl will add in the carbon, so one bond accepted by nitrogen is becoming lone pair electron. The product double bond CX. If you take Cl2, ClCl will come. Next, sulfur. If you take sulfur on addition with sulfur isocyanide, yes, simply that one of the bond from triple bond will shift as a lone pair electron. So CH3N double bond C double bond S. Next we are going to take with oxygen. CH3N triple bond N with the oxygen will give isocyanide. CH3N double bond C double bond O. This is called isothiocyanide. This is called isocyanide. Okay. So all the chemical property of isocyanide we have finished. Now we are going to see the uses of nitro compound and also cyanide compound. So the nitro alkanes, nitro compounds very important. So it is used in fuels for cars. So in the car fuel, small amount we can use nitroalkane. Particularly we can write nitromethane used in cars fuel. Next, chloropicrene. What is the molecular formula for chloropicrene? CCl3NO2. It is used as a insecticide, right? Insect killing compound. Next, we can use that nitroalkanes. It is a precursor of additive to petrol. So along with petrol, you can use some amount. Okay. Then it is also used as a many other compound like ester or cyanide, rubber compounds, dyes we can prepare by using nitro compounds. Okay. At last, very important, the 4% of nitroethane, that is ethyl nitrile. 4% of ethyl nitrile in alcohol medium is called sweet spirit, right? Spirit, we know that alcohol, this is called sweet spirit. Okay, it is used in diuretic. Okay, it is also used as a fuel. Okay, next we are going to see about nitrobenzene. See, nitro compound, alkane nitro compound we have finished, nitrobenzene. Many other compound we can prepare by using this nitrobenzene compound. Okay, like lubricating oils we can prepare, then TNT, trinitrotoluene, TNB, trinitroboron compound. Like many compounds we can prepare by using nitrobenzene. Now we are going to see the uses of cyanide as well as isocyanide. So the cyanide, which is used to prepare large number of other compound, it is acting as a intermediate. Okay, then in the textile industry also we are using the cyanide compound. Okay, thank you.